The legislature just hit the halfway mark of the 2017 session, so bring us up to date on the progress so far.
Yeah, we are indeed halfway through the session now, and we've been out on the floor all week long voting on bills, getting the bills out of the House over to the Senate so we can keep going. So I came out here to the rotunda to give this this update today and give you all a great view behind me of the House rotunda. Now, as we've moved forward, both the House Democrats and the Senate Republicans have released their education plans. The best thing about this is the fact that they've came out early so we can get to negotiating really quick. The strong point about the Senate Republican plan is that it has the money backing to push that bill forward. The bill is funded, whereas the House Democrat plan does not include any funding, and that's the weak side of their plan. It's a policy bill only, and we don't know how they plan to move that bill forward with no funding. We don't know what kind of new revenues or new taxes they might be asking for in the future, and that's something that's very concerning to us. But be encouraged by the fact that these bills are both out early, and now we can really get down to the brass tacks of negotiating our final bill in that respect. You know, both of these bills are posturing. The Senate Republican bill came over on one side, the House Democrat bill came over on the other side. In the end, we're gonna see a good coming to the middle and a good compromise bill that'll drive our education forward.
As you mentioned, legislators are on the House floor voting on bills. You've had three bills that have come out of the House this week. Talk about those.
Yeah, I'm really excited to talk about those today. So one of my bills is specific to veterans. So when veterans are transitioning from their active duty to civilian life, many of them go on what's called terminal leave. That's burning up the leave that they have left available on the books, and then they can kind of get out there into the world a little bit early. But current law does not allow them to define themselves as veterans. My bill, which passed the House this week unanimously, does exactly that. It defines them as veterans. So when it comes down to civil service points, they can claim those special veterans points and get kind of a leg up on any civil service jobs. Another bill that I'm really happy passed honors the life of this fine lady that I came to know down here in Olympia, Gina Bull. Gina raised her family in Oak Harbor, and she originally grew up in the Walla Walla area and was the daughter of one of our legislators. She recently passed away, and her last job before her passing was as the House Page Supervisor. One of her last wishes was to create a scholarship program that would allow indigent students to come over here in Page, and if they weren't able to afford their room and board, this fund would be created to help them with that. That bill also passed off the House floor unanimously, and I was very happy to honor Gina with a resolution that very same day. Her family was in town, and it was really a wonderful experience for them. And lastly, another bill that I had is a good public safety bill. Child crimes detectives from across the state have been seeing issues with people who are designated as mandatory reporters of child sex crimes or abuse crimes that were not reporting potential abuse and criminal behavior correctly. So what this bill does is requires DSHS to develop a poster and then make that poster available online so employers of mandatory reporters, doctor's offices, police officers, firefighters, teachers, folks like that, those employers would post that letter and remind those mandatory reporters of their responsibility in those situations. That bill also moved off the House floor unanimously. So it's something that I'm very proud of. It's going to be a good public safety bill.
If people want more information about these bills or to contact you, how do they go about doing that?
Oh, I sure hope that people do continue to contact me and ask me questions about legislation or anything within state government. You can do so by contacting me through my website and my email address, or telephoning the hotline or my desk here in Olympia.